大家好 ，Hello everybody， 我是 Jack。
大家好 ，Hello everybody， 我是 Sunny。
Perfect.
So Jack, I have a question for you.
Okay.
So, do you like hot pot?
Yes, I do like hot pots.
So, what dish do you like best when you have
roll? Always roll.
I have finished my question.
I already know the answer. Though. I'm just being quick.
我刚刚问 Jack， 他吃火锅的时候最喜欢吃哪一道菜？他说肉。
Raw.
So do you like beef or pork or goat?
Goat? You mean sheep? Shouldn't it be sheep in hot pot?
羊肉。
羊肉，对。
Oh, it should be sheep, right?
Yeah.
火锅中的那个羊肉应该是 sheep, not goat. So.
但是 I have eaten goat hot pot before, and it's 好好吃，
特
别好吃。
他说，除了吃火锅的时候吃到那个肥羊卷之外，他还吃过山羊 goat 做的那种炖的火锅，也非常的好吃，特别好吃。So what's the difference between sheep and goat? Can you tell?
Well, when I was young, I used to think sheep was girl.Goat was boy, but obviously that's not true. It's a different animal. Goat is the one with the horns who live on the mountain, you know, climb over the rocks. And sheep is the fluffy one that we cut the hair off and put inside soft things.
所以说 sheep 和 goat 是两种不一样的生物。So we call sheep 绵羊。
绵羊，对。
And we call goat...山羊，
山羊，
山羊是有那个 big horns， 是有角的那种，在山地中行走的羊，应该是这样啊。然后绵羊我们会 cut their hairs， 我们会剪掉它们的毛，然后用来吃东西啊，各种各样的。
We can also eat lamb, and lamb is just baby sheep.
Baby sheep.
Yeah.
我们还常常说那个羊羔肉，羔羊肉就是 lamb, L-A-M.B 这个 B 是不发音的，它那么这个 lamb 就是 baby sheep， 就是小一点的羊。Usually they're not 1 year old, right?
I think they are kind of about that age. I think they're about 1 or 2. They're very young.
No, I、
usually.
Think they're below 1.
Are they? I don't know.
Because I googled it.
Oh right. Okay.
然后我查了一下，上网查了一下，通常我们说这个 lamb 小羊羔呢是在一岁以下的，我们会把它叫做小羊羔羔羊肉。那么如果是一岁以上的 ，so if they are more than 1 year old, we call it
sheep.
Mutton.
Mutton. Yes.
M U T T O N 也是 O N， 这个 N 有点太用力了，也是指羊肉，是指一岁以上的稍微老一点的羊肉。那么其实说到羊呢，大家可能还会想到十二生肖。So Jack, do you know anything about Chinese zodiacs?
我知道我是鼠年的。
Pardon?
我是鼠年的。I'm
the year of the rat.
Yes.
对，强子说他是鼠年的。老鼠的鼠 the year of the rat. 那么如果你想要表达羊年应该怎么说呢？ How to say 羊年？
Sheep, year of the sheep.
But why is it not the year of the goat?
That's a good question. I thought it was the goat originally, but apparently it's not. Apparently it is actually the sheep.
Why? But...
Why? Because sheep taste good. More tasty than goat. I don't
Maybe
know.
Maybe sheep has some positive meanings, right? So
yeah.
You guys love sheep more.
They're fluffy and they're cute, I guess.
And they taste good.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm looking for, I suppose.
其实大家如果要说羊年的话，应该要说 the year of the sheep. 因为虽然在汉语中我们说羊，说我们对羊的概念都是差不多的，说 sheep 或者是 goat 山羊或者绵羊，对我们来说感觉都很像，但是在英文中其实不是这样的。 sheep 绵羊这个单词通常是比较正面的含义，而 goat 山羊通常是比较贬义的感觉。所以说如果大家想要表达羊年的话，尽量还是多用这个 the year of the sheep。 当然如果你要说 the year of the goat 其实也是没有问题的啦。
I think the year of the dragon is the best one, isn't it?
No? The year of the rooster is the best one.
I thought it was the year of the chicken. Year of the
The rooster. It should be the year of the rooster because I was born in the year of the rooster. So
this is why it's
the rooster
the
is the best one. Yes,
of
because、
course.
Sunny is the best.
Yeah, 当然了。对不起，I should have 不好意思，I should have known.
强子说他觉得农 好难。龙年是最好的，其实我觉得不是啊，我觉得生肖最好的是鸡 ，because I was born in the year of the rooster，不是 the year of the chicken， but the year of the rooster， right？
好。
Okay, so today we're going to be taking a look at some sheep-related expressions and idioms.
说了这么多，大家应该都知道，今天我们就要来聊一聊关于羊的一些表达和俚语。So, what's our first one?
好的，第一个 sheepish.
Sheepish.
Yes.
So what is sheepish?
S-H-E-E-P-I-S-H. So this is when you look embarrassed or you're a little bit uncomfortable、mm-hmm. because of something embarrassing or...something bad you have done. So,
好尴尬
yeah, 好尴尬、
right?
不好意思 just, you know, like, you feel embarrassed, and it's the face
because
you
Because that you have done something wrong, right?
Yeah, exactly.
这个单词是表示当你做一些比较蠢或者是做错一些事情的时候你会觉得有一些不舒服有点局促不安有点困窘的感觉 So Jack, can you give us an example sentence?
Yeah, of course. He looked sheepishly at his parents when they found out what he had done.
当他的爸爸妈妈发现他做的事情之后呢，他就不好意思，非常困窘的看着他的爸爸妈妈。Or I can say that Jack looked sheepish for he ate Sunny's sandwich.
By accident. It has to be an accident.
By accident, okay.
Yeah, I wouldn't eat it by accident. I would eat on purpose, but you have
Why?
To. It has to be. It has to be an accident for it to be sheepish.
我刚刚说这个例句是，Jack 看上去非常的不好意思，因为他吃了我的三明治。然后 Jack 说是 by accident. It has to be by accident. 就是说这个事情一定是你是不小心做错的，你才可以用这个 sheepish.
Okay, so next up we have like sheep.
Like sheep,、像羊一样。
Yeah, so this is when, when people are behaving like sheep,、mm-hmm. they do not think independently, they just follow what everyone else does or what somebody tells them to do.、
其实这个 like sheep 就是表示人们没有主见、盲从、就是人云亦云的感觉。So, can I say thatBoyfriends are led around the shopping mall like sheep.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they're definitely not thinking, so they're acting like sheep.
我刚刚说的是那些男朋友陪女朋友逛街的时候，在那个商场里面就跟 sheep 一样被我们牵着到处走。这就是我们所说的 like sheep， 表示没有主见，盲从的意思。
Okay, so next we have to make sheep's eyes at somebody. This is to give somebody an adoring, loving look. It's, you know, when you're totally
in love with
somebody. Yeah, you're staring at them like a sheep looks at grass.
第三个是 make sheep's eyes at someone. 就是说充满爱意的看着某人。So can you give us an example sentence?
Yeah, so an example sentence could be, it's strange...But he has been giving me sheep's eyes all morning.
All morning.
Yeah.
That's pretty long.
Yeah.
Okay, so the next one we're going to take a look at is a wolf in sheep's clothing.
Yeah, very popular one.
Mm-hmm. 披着羊皮的狼。
说一遍。
披着羊皮的狼。
No, forget it.
披着。
披着。
羊皮。
披着羊皮，披着单。
披着羊皮的狼，
的狼哦。
Okay, all together.
披着一
羊皮。
Oh, I'm sorry.
Too much for you. Okay,
我好累啊。
Okay, so this one means a person or thing that appears harmless but is actually very dangerous or bad.
Yeah. So, an example sentence would be,
"Don't trust Jack.
Oh,
he's a wolf in sheep's clothing who
yeah.
will try to steal your sandwich."
That's a very good example sense, yeah.
不要相信 Jack, 他就是一条披着羊皮的狼,他会吃掉我的三明治。
三明治,好, sounds good. Alright, so next up we have might as well be hanged for a sheep as a lamb.
Might as well be hanged, so hand means that you're hanged, right?
Yeah, so H-A-N-G-E-D, so this is when you're killed by a rope, they hang your neck.
被吊死。
So
what does this one mean?
So this is when you say you might as well commit a bad offense、rather than commit a small offense because the punishment will be the same.、So you'll still get the same treatment if it's a bad crime or a small crime. If, you know, a small crime.
So in Chinese,
you can explain better in Chinese, I think.
So in Chinese, we can say 一不做二不休。
一不做二不休。
就是反正最后的结果都是这样，反正你已经做什么都是这个结果了，就干脆想怎么干就怎么干，一不做二不休的意思。So for example, I've already blown most of my savings, so what's another $100? Might as well be hand for a sheep as a lamb.我已经失去了我大部分的存款了，所以说这一百块钱又算什么呢？干脆一不做二不休，讲不好还能挣。
Yeah, so this is just a way of saying, you know, you might as well do something the whole way rather than doing it a little bit.
就是说干脆直截了当把这件事情做到底，就是不要只做一个开头那种感觉。
Okay, so an example sentence would be, shall we rob the big bank or the small bank, Sonny?
So I can say, might as well be hand for sheep as a lamb.
Meaning,
反正都是要抢，干脆抢大的。
Let's rob the big bank.
More money, right?
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so moving on from sheep to goats. The first one I can think of for goats is...Don't act the goat or don't play the goat.
Or play the goat.
Yeah, act or play. So this is...
玩山羊。
玩山羊。你知道
吗? I don't know.
Okay, so I don't know what you said anyway. So this is when you are just being stupid or silly on purpose to annoy somebody.
Is it like fool around?
Yeah, basically, yeah. You're just fooling around. You're just annoying somebody.
Something stupid.
Basically, yeah.So, Sunny's students often act the goat, 对吧?
Yeah. 这个 act or play the goat, 就是说你干蠢事就是瞎胡闹的那种感觉就是那种 fool around, 有种这样的意思在里面。So, we can say that stop acting the goat or I'll send you out, I'm warning you.
Yeah.、
Definitely. 不要再胡闹了如果你再这样我就把你送出去我再警告你哦我经常对我学生说这句话。Okay, so the next one we're going to take a look at is get somebody's goat. So,
get somebody's goat. Yeah, that's...
You guess the meaning?
It's kind of like to annoy somebody very much. I think maybe goats are considered annoying because I think all of the expressions about them are about annoying people. So I would guess it's something like that.
Okay, so this one actually means annoy somebody very much, like irritate someone.
Okay, right, yeah. So to irritate somebody, that's like...
Hey, don't get my goat, Jack.
Yeah, really annoy someone. Don't get my goat, don't get my goat. Stop acting the goat.
I have a short fuse.
Yeah, exactly.
这个 get somebody's goat, 就是说惹怒某人,激怒某人的意思。你可以说, it really gets my goat when people smoke...In non-smoking areas, 人们在那种禁烟区抽烟真的是非常让我生气这种感觉或者你可以直接对别人说 Hey, don't get my goat, 不要让我生气了
Right, so that's all we've got for you today when it comes to sheep and goats, but yeah, try and remember the difference between them、mm-hmm. and when it's correct to use them, so don't say acting the sheep or playing the sheep, blah,、mm-hmm. blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, despite they have similar appearance, but they have completely different meanings in English.
Yeah,
so,
try not to mix them up.
Yeah, that was my line.
I beat you to it. I knew I couldn't help but jumping in, sorry.
这一期关于 sheep 和 goat 的一些表达我们就聊到这儿了。
Hello, welcome to Morning English.早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道每天都会更新如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容我们都会在这个频道更新我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语如果你觉得还不错的话记得给我们订阅哦另外点开小铃铛这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦对了如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记在视频简介或者评论区领取哦你也可以给这个视频点赞点赞就相当于自动保存啦
Alright, that's what we have for today, and thank you guys for listening. So,
yeah,
I've been Sunny.
Thanks for listening as always. I've been Jack. See you next time, guys.
Have a nice day. Bye-bye.
Bye.